pass in those days that a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be registered. This census first took place while Quirinius was governing Syria. So all went to be registered, everyone to his own city. Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be registered with Mary, his betrothed wife, who was with child. So it was that while they were there, the days were completed for her to be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn.
Thank you.
And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill to men."
So it was, when the angels had gone away from them into heaven, that the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has come to pass, which the Lord has made known to us." And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph in the babe lying in a manger. Now, when they had seen him, they made widely known the saying which was told to them concerning this child. And all those who heard it marveled at those things which were told to them by the shepherds. But Mary kept all these things and pondered them in her heart. Then the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things that they had heard and seen as it was told to them.
Wild fields and floods, cross fields and plains.
days for purification according to the law of Moses were completed, they brought him to Jerusalem to present him to the Lord. As it is written in the law of the Lord, every male who opens the womb shall be called holy to the Lord. And to offer a sacrifice according to what is said in the law of the Lord, a pair of turtle doves and two young pigeons.
And behold, there was a man in Jerusalem whose name was Simeon. And this man was just and devout, waiting for the consultation of Israel, and the Holy Spirit was upon him. And it had been revealed to him by the Holy Spirit that he would not see death before he had seen the Lord's Christ. So he came by the Spirit unto the temple, and when the parents brought the child Jesus to do for him according to custom of the law, he took him up in his arms and blessed God and said, Lord, now you are letting your servant depart in peace, according to your word. For my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared before the faces of all peoples, a light to bring revelation to the Gentiles and the glory of your people Israel. And Joseph and his mother marveled at those things which were spoken of him. Then Simeon blessed them and said to Mary, his mother, behold, this child is destined to for the fall and rising of many in Israel, and for a sign which will be spoken against. Yes, a sword will pierce through your own soul also, that the thoughts of many hearts may be revealed.
Now there was one, Anna, a prophetess, the daughter of Phanuel, of the tribe of Asher. She was of a great age and had lived with a husband of 7 years. She was a widow of about 84 years, who did not depart from the temple, but served God with fastings and prayer night and day. And coming in that instant, she gave thanks to the Lord and spoke of him to all those who looked for redemption in Jerusalem.
Thank you. Wasn't that awesome?
Yeah.
Woo!
Woo!
At this time, we'd like to ask all of our parents and grandparents of one of these incredible young people, would you please stand at this time? Look at that. Look at that. Look at these proud moments. Woo! You guys are awesome. Thank you so much. You guys are awesome. You guys are awesome. Wow. I'll tell you what, I don't know if y'all noticed this or not, but when those two boys had a hold of those tassels, they were waving them in unison. Boy, that was awesome. It was incredible. Never seen anything like it. It was good. Well, the Lord has been good to us, hasn't he?
Amen.
Yeah. At this time, on November the 15th, this past November the 15th, I came in as pastor to a very incredible church family here at Happy Home. Through the labor of a very faithful servant of God. Servants of God. And Reverend Don Caskey and his wife, Sister Crystal, and Mama Jean, have been a tremendous guiding, leading factor in this church over the past year, over the previous year. So I came into a very, very good situation here. Found a very loving congregation and found a faithful man and woman of God, so his family, who have been here laboring faithfully for all this time. So this time, I'd like to ask Reverend Caskey and his family to come now. And I'd like to ask our deacons and our elders to please come at this time. Our deacons and our elders. Today is a unique day in our church family. Today is Pastor Don's last Sunday. And so at this time I'd like to ask, I'm going to ask Elder Walter Byron to come now and say some things about Pastor Don. And also, they're going to have a special leading of prayer, a special commissioning, a special release for Pastor Don and his family. Elder Byron.
I'm not going to come into agreement with what Pastor Tommy said. He said this was going to be Pastor Don's last Sunday. I'll just complete your sentence. It's his last Sunday here.
Last Sunday here.
Some of you may know, some of you may not know, but Pastor Don and I have been meeting together almost weekly on Thursday mornings, and it's been a very good time for me of growth, of discipleship, sitting under Pastor Don as we challenge one another as iron sharpens iron. And just wanted to just tell both of them that we appreciate your ministry. Pastor Don and Miss Crystal, both of them are drivers. And if you're going to hold on to the plow, you better hold on tightly. Because the plow is going forward, and it's not going to be slowly. It's going to be advancing. And that's what I think we should all grabbed hold of, that we should advance the gospel, and that we should do it promptly, and we should do it quickly. And I appreciate their labors of love, their labors of sacrifice, and the short while that they've been here, what's been planted here, and what's been watered, and what you have fertilized. And we appreciate it. And I'm going to turn it over to Ms. Tammy in just a moment to lead our prayer. And we're going to all pray together. I've got one other thing after we do this. But I wanted a lady's voice in this, Tammy.
Okay.
The thing that I recognize about these two people is they know how to read the giftings in people, and how to administer and how to place people in position. And that is a gift of God, and I appreciate them applying that to our church and our church family. And I'm not going to ask for a thing of hand clap, because that accolades are good, but it's all for His name's sake and for the advancement of the gospel. And Miss Gina, we love you, and we tear up in times as this, but we're thankful to God that you have passed our way. And hopefully our family, our church family, has been a blessing to you as well, because you certainly have been faithful and to us with your smile and encouragement. So I'm going to ask Tammy if she would to come and pray.
Hallelujah. God, we want to just start out by thanking you for the season, Lord, that you have had us in the past year. A time of transitioning and a time of shifting, a time of plowing, a time of plucking, God, a time of moving, God, a time of building. God, we thank you, God, for the season, God, and we thank you, God, for the vessels, oh God, that you use, God, during this time. Hallelujah. God, I thank you, God, for their hearts, hallelujah, today, oh God. They didn't come, Lord, just to pursue in a program. God, they didn't come, oh Lord, just to use some good ideas. But God, they came with hearts open and ready, God, to be vessels of God of use, hallelujah. God, to flow with the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah, God. I just thank you for these lives, oh God. And I just release them, oh God, at this time. God, in this moment, in this season of Happy Home. God, we release them, oh God, to their next season. God, into their next ministry, oh God. God, and I pray even now, God, you start to highlight the door. Hallelujah, God. I pray for the stepping stones, God, that you have, oh God, in front of Mr. and Mrs. Caskey, God, the pastors, oh God. God, that you would just start to highlight the stones, oh God, that they are charged to step on, oh God. Highlight them, oh God. Protect them, oh God. God, be with their feet, oh God. Guide them, God. God, as they rest in you, God, and walk in a peace with you, oh Lord. Hallelujah. Start, Lord. Start that faith, oh God. Expand that faith, oh God, even right now, God. God, they didn't know us there, God. Press, oh God. Open it, Lord, right now. Hallelujah. In their spirit, God. That, Lord, which you're starting to birth, oh God, right now, Lord. That, Lord, which you're starting to birth out, oh God, for the next season, oh God. Hallelujah, Lord. We pray protection for it, oh God. God, and we pray for completion in Jesus' name. God, we worship you, God. Hallelujah, God. We say it's not done yet. Hallelujah. It's not done yet, Pastor Don. It's not done yet, Miss Crystal. It's not done yet, Miss Jean. Hallelujah. God, there's still something else to be done. Hallelujah, Lord. When we just praise your holy name. God, we pray blessings. God, you know, oh God, the provision, oh God, that is needed, oh God. God, you know the divine connections that are, God, that are still needed, oh God, to be put in place. God, and you know the home, oh God, to be brought forth, oh Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. We just praise your holy name. And we lift you up, oh God. We glorify you, Lord. And we just thank you, God, for the testimony, Lord, that will come, oh God, out of these lives, oh God, that stand before us today, Lord. We pray all this, oh God, and we come in agreement right now in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Wow. This has been wonderful. Thank you all for allowing us to serve you. I'll let Ms. Crystal say something too if she would like. But you know what's really interesting is many of you know that God miraculously healed me. And it was interesting that I, of course, been praying for this for a couple of years now. I've had this problem a couple of years, was losing my hearing. And God did not heal me until my job here was done.
Right. Yes.
And I believe that God, I was looking forward to an operation and was going to be recuperating for 6 months to a year. And I wasn't able going to do any, be able to do really any ministry. But God healed me, and I think we all can agree that there must be something next.
Yes.
And it must be, it must be, yes. Get God a praise. I don't have a formula for healing. God heals in His wisdom and His guidance and His plan. But I would my testimony is that you guys healed me. Your prayers and allowing me to serve you and allowing me to come here. You've given us far more than we've ever given you. And it's been a privilege to serve you, and it's been a privilege. And we are just so excited about Pastor Tommy and the future of this church. And we just look for great things. We know that this is the launch pad, and all the woos that are going to be coming. And we're excited about all that. So. But thank you, each and every one, for your patience with me. I know that I've made mistakes, and you've been forgiving on that. And I thank you for your encouragement and prayers. And we just look forward. It's all about the kingdom, amen. And we appreciate the leadership here, team. Here, I'm in the leadership of the conference. Many of you know that, and we work with 71 churches, and I'm responsible for many of those churches that are in conflict. And you have probably the best. One of the best, if not the best, leadership team. Give them a hand. They are a great group of people. You are so blessed to have them. They are truly men and women of God, and you're truly blessed to have them. Amen.
When Don first took the interim, I was down in South Carolina. Mother Jean and I were down in South Carolina, and the board was gracious enough to allow Mother Jean and I to come up and stay in the parsonage. And because of circumstances of jobs and things of that nature, it's our first opportunity in almost 3 years to actually live together for an extended period of time. It was really nice. I discovered I really like this guy. I like having him around. But I was very spiritually dry when I came here. God showed me a vision when I first got here of this very dry riverbed. And this little plant trying to grow up in this little dry riverbed. And through the praise and worship and the godly teaching and the wonderful leadership of this church and different things, God gave me a new vision not too long ago of that same river.
Yay, yay.
It wasn't a dry riverbed
yay.
Anymore.
Yay.
And that little plant was glowing and
yay.
Growing and flourishing. I just thank God for this church because you have ministered to me in a mighty way. I just want to bless you for blessing me. Thank you.
What you doing in our lives? Spirit guide. And we love you.
We like some brownies.
Well, I too appreciate all that you guys have done for our church and for us personally during this time. You've been a big help to me as treasurer of the church and in the position you serve in on the conference leadership team as treasurer there. And as a very small token of our appreciation, we are going to bless you with two additional weeks' pay. That'll be direct deposit if we don't have a check to hand you this morning. But
I like it better.
That's right. Miss Crystal does too. Yeah. But we do appreciate all that you've done. We love you.
Appreciate it. Amen. Let's give the Lord praise. Amen. I thought we were going to have a paper check. That's the reason why I was trying to draw. You know, we didn't have that. So it's automatic deposit. That's the way we do things nowadays.
That's right.
So at this time, we'd like to have Sister Joyce come. She'd like to share something about the Christmas program. And then Elder Walter will close. We'll close us out in prayer. Sister Joyce, you've got something about the Christmas program.
I just want to say a special thanks to Teresa. She has been a great help in helping to practice and to organize these kids with all their parts. And we just want to say a special thanks to her. And also I'd like to thank Scott and Lynette for the background. They did all the painting in the background that you see. And also Debbie has been a great support. And I have Andrea, who helped with the costumes. I don't want to forget her. And also Team Jesus. These young people are learning leadership, and they're learning how to cooperate with us and to get the job done. And they're 18 years. Thank you all, and I enjoyed working with you.
Amen. Special thanks also. There were some real troopers last night that were helping me move. So they did so in the rain. These folks came, and they went to Grandy last night with a big trailer. And in the pouring down rain to move stuff from Grandy out here last night, there were torrential downpours, but the Lord was so faithful to help move last night. Brother Firma, Brother James, Elder Walt, Sister Robin, Sister Beth. All that came out last night, and we're just, Brother Brian, were such a blessing to me last night in helping move. So let's give the Lord praise offering to these guys. At this time, Elder Walter is going to close us out in prayer. We pass it around.
Yeah, much of this at the end is unscripted for sure. Right, Tammy? This season we celebrate, and even though we weep, there are tears of joy, and we just thank you and we send you forth, and we ask for reports back.
Yes, we will.
I ask permission to do this. So I'm gonna ask Prophet Miss Rose if you would prophetess, I should say. Ms. Rose, please come up here. Most of the time I call her Sister Rose, but I know she walks in a prophetic gifting.
Come on.
And I scolded her, or I got after her one time. I want whoever's up here to kind of get around her. We're getting ready to pray over her. Because she has a way of disappearing for a while, and she won't tell you where she's going. She'll tell you after she's been. Well, I ask her not to do that to me anymore. She's getting ready to do some visiting in the Denver area with her family, her son. But when she goes, when she leaves, she is on mission. Just as the Caskies are departing this campus today differently, They have purpose in that. And Miss Rose, we ask that the Lord would give you good times of celebration with your family, but that He would, the Spirit would give you the words to say, and that He would give you vision when the door is open to speak to the right people. So I'm going to ask as we get ready to leave here today, I want to just pray over Miss Rose. We speak a blessing over all of you. We ask that the Lord, His grace and His love would rest upon you. The peace of the living God would not just settle on you, but would go and cloak you as you leave here to be lights of the gospel of the living Christ. The story doesn't end in the manger scene. We know that, right? So let's ask if you would all stand. We ask that the ones who feel comfortable, we ask that you'd reach your hands out to Miss Rose as we pray over her. So Father, we thank you for our sister. We thank you for the gift that you've placed in her life. God, we pray, Lord, just that her pathway as she goes, Lord, would be smooth. God, we ask that you would be with her. We ask that you would encircle her with your angels, God. And let the protection, God, let us pray for eyes that can see, ears that hear, and the mouthpiece, Lord, you said would be effective. And it would break the bondage and set the captives free. So God, we know that.
It's been good to be in the presence of the Lord. Give the Lord a praise offering. We will have evening service tonight at 6 p.m. We'll be looking at the keys for effective Christmas shopping. The biblical keys of how to buy how to get just the right gift from the scripture. It's going to be incredible. So we will have that tonight at 6 o'clock. Before you leave today, come by and greet Pastor Caskey and Sister Crystal as they go. And may the Lord bless you in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.